Rogers is covered in the film, they go, oh, how could this have happened? You can absolutely see how this could have happened. It was a time before TMZ and everything else in Hollywood. If you look back, that was, you know, secrets were held.
Yeah, I mean, I think I might prefer that to you, Scotty, because one thing that I've discovered in the course of making the film and talking to so many people coming up to me and saying, you're making that movie, I don't believe it. I don't believe the book. Which puzzled me, especially after going down the road with Scotty and researching it so much. But do you have any comments to make, Scotty, about why you think people don't, or initially didn't believe you when you wrote the book and talked right in there?
That would be up to them, not me, you know.
you said something the other day at screening, which is something like, like you finished it, was like, just because it didn't happen to you, it didn't happen. What's your take on that?
That was more or less what I said. Because it didn't happen to them, doesn't mean it didn't happen.
You know, Scotty, it's interesting. I know the book, you know, it's been out a few years, but to see it play out on the big screen like this and see your life there, what was it like when you saw the finished film and looked at this?
Meaning Matt put it together very nicely, and there's more to it than that, and I liked it very much.
When you show film to your subject, it's always tense. It wasn't tense for him, because I think he's so extraordinarily adjusted in so many ways. But he gave me the best comment I ever got from the subject of the film. It was very simple. It was, the music is happy and the words are happy too. And the music was very expensive, I told him, also, so he had another reason.
Yeah. When I'm looking at, you know, there's a television series from the 50s, The Naked City, and they say there's a million stories in The Naked City. In your case, Scotty, it's literally true. There are a million stories in The Naked City here that you you brought out. And, you know, I thought it was interesting when you were at the book signing and you were confronted by the guy that you were shooting there and saying, how can you do this? How can you do this now? And, you know, because obviously you kept these secrets for so many decades.
Well, you can't really, you don't, they were all friends, so you don't do it while they're living.
Yeah.
And once you're dead, you're dead.
Yeah.
And I wrote that in the Marine Corps. How many guys died each day?
Yeah, it was the gentleman in the Palm Springs bookstore, I think, is emblematic of a kind of, there's certain categories, the doubters, and then there's a kind of moralistic reaction against a tell-all book, and what eventually in our culture became a tallying. And I think that Scotty has every right to tell a story. It's his story, I think all aspects of it. There are many aspects of the story that bother people. But it's his story after all, so I thought making Citizen of Entertainment movie for the most part, it was a great opportunity to let him tell the story as he sees it.
What I thought was great, Scotty, was to see how the film also dealt with the emerging AIDS crisis and then the Supreme Court decision on gay marriage and your reactions to those in the film, too. I thought it brought it full circle, as it were.
It's interesting, in the film, we imply that you stopped drinking around the time of AIDS. What was your feeling at that moment, and did you stop drinking entirely then?
Well, sure, cut down a lot.
So you went from 200 a day to 10.
I know you said you were always busy, couldn't do the birthday dinners and things like that. I mean, that was a busy time, obviously.
It was a very busy time. I mean, night and day and night. Like a song, day and night and day.
Yeah. Cole Porter, one of the... Yeah, you know what I loved about the film, though, Scotty, and watching you hear the same thing? You know, your smile and your laugh. And the way you looked so matter-of-factly about something a lot of people put fences around and different things and are hung up about.
Oh yeah, many people are hung up about a lot of things and always will be. And better let them just go and be hung up.
Yeah. And at 95 and 5 days, I just got notification 2 days ago that you just joined Twitter. You are now on Twitter.
Oh, really?
Yes. And I actually got a tweet from you this morning, which I'm sure was probably written by the person that put you on Twitter, but it was very nice putting it out there. You know, Scotty Bowers moving right into these times here with that.
Oh, that's nice.